Hello everyone, welcome to the third module of HUT 200 Professional Ethics. To the previous modules, we had covered the basic concepts which are essential for a thorough understanding of professional ethics. In the first module, we covered some of the essential human values, and in the second module, we covered the different theories of moral development as well as some important ethical theories. In this module, we'll be focusing on the roles and responsibilities of engineers as responsible experimenters and how engineering experiments influence social and cultural systems of human society and why engineering is regarded as a social experiment. In this presentation, we will be covering three important topics: engineering as social experimentation, the similarities and differences between engineering experiments as well as standard experiments, and finally, engineers as responsible experimenters. The processes involved in engineering have a long-lasting impact on society and its development. Apart from technological advancements, all engineering experiments affect society and societal beings. The processes involved in engineering are not solely restricted to laboratories or computers in simulated or controlled conditions. These experiments affect and are conducted on a social scale as well. Every new creation is a long and tedious process that involves multiple steps, and these experiments create an impact on the current technological as well as social scenario. After the design is formulated, at every further step it is tested for its impact on the society, and if found harmful, is redirected for design rectification. The very same routine continues till the manufacturing of the product, and even after it is launched for public use. For example, the new updates installed into each new edition of smartphone is a result of thorough research on the requirements of people following countless rectifications and developments on the existing design. Thus, designing a new product is an iterative process that moves through the following steps, retracting back to the previous one until it is perfected. The first step is design. Unlike in fairy tales, we cannot conjure things from thin air. Every product needs a design, an image or plan based on which the product is made. The next step is to fabricate or assemble the aids that are required to make the product. The third step is prototype or model study. Before moving forward to make the final product, it is necessary to make a prototype to analyze any flaws or rectifications that are necessary in the final product. Prototype or model study helps to eliminate the massive expenditure from failures, if any are to occur at the final step. Then comes the final study. After eliminating any potential risks or complications, we move to the final study. After getting approved at the final study, we move on to manufacturing of the product. This is the end product that is delivered to the customers. Now we can see the rigorous process behind manufacturing any product from its design stage. Even after manufacturing, the process is not over yet. Once the product is out in the market, the marketing experts will have to conduct a field study to analyze how the product is being received so that they can make the necessary developments in the next design or product. Now, we shall move on to the next topic, which is the differences and similarities between engineering and standard experiments. While standard experiments analyze how things work, engineers create new things, such as products, websites, environments, and experiences. Because engineering and standard experiments have different objectives, they follow different processes in their work. We shall now compare these two activities and identify the similarities and contrasts between the two. We shall first look into the similarities between the two. The first similarity between engineering as well as standard experiments is the partial ignorance. Engineering experiments, like standard experiments, are carried out in partial ignorance. The behavior of materials purchased is uncertain and not constant. They may vary with the suppliers, process lot, time, and the process used in shaping the materials. There may be variations in the grain structure and its resulting failure stress. It is not possible to collect data on all variations. In some cases, extrapolation, interpolation, assumptions of linear behavior over the range of parameters, accelerated testing, simulations, and virtual testing are resorted to. The second similarity between the two is uncertainty. Since many of the experiments are conducted in partial ignorance, the results are also usually uncertain. While the experiments may yield the desired results, they might also cause many undesirable side effects and may involve some unexpected risks. Some of these uncertainties are found in design calculation, exact properties of the raw materials used, and the nature of the working of the final product. Another similarity is continuous monitoring. Similar to standard experiments, engineering experiments also require thorough knowledge about the products at the pre-production and post-production stages. Thus, engineering, like any other experimentation, requires constant monitoring, alertness, and vigil on the part of the engineers at every stage of the project. The fourth similarity is learning from the past. Engineers normally learn from their own prior designs and infer from the analysis of the operation and results, and sometimes from the reports of other engineers. But this does not happen frequently. The absence of interests and channels of communication, ego in not seeking information, guilt upon the failure, fear of legal actions, and mere negligence have caused many failures. The complacency that it will not happen again and will not happen to me has led to many, many disasters. It is obvious that engineering experiments differ from standard experiments. Understanding the differences between engineering and other standard experiments is helpful to the engineers to realize their ethical and moral responsibilities. Let us now analyze some aspects of these differences. The first difference is experimental control. Experimental control is the most important difference between engineering and other standard experiments. In standard experiments, experimental control involves selecting members for two random groups. The members of the first group are given special experimental treatment. The group not given any special treatment is called control group, and this process is called experimental control. In engineering experiments, usually there is no control group. Sometimes the control group is used only when the project is limited to laboratory experiments. The second difference is the factor of human touch. Since the outputs of engineering experiments are for public use, the insights, requirements, and feedback of the public is necessary for the development of new products. Informed consent is an important difference between engineering and standard experiments. As an ethical doctrine, informed consent is a process of communication whereby a patient is enabled to make an informed and voluntary decision about accepting or declining medical care. The idea of informed consent has little relevance to engineering. The idea's natural habitat is said to lie in professions like medicine, where there are clearly identifiable patients or experimental subjects who have the right to make autonomous decisions about procedures affecting them. Since engineering projects have unforeseen effects on unforeseen victims, it is sometimes difficult to identify who should give or withhold informed consent. The main two elements of informed consent is knowledge and voluntariness. The human subjects should be given all the information to make a reasonable decision, and they should partake willingly without being forced or deceived. Informed consent can be called valid consent when the consent should be given voluntarily and should be based on all the information needed for a rational person to make a reasonable decision. Also, the consenter should be competent enough to process the information and to make reasonable decisions. The final difference between the two is the knowledge gained from the experiments. According to Harvard Professor Taft Broome, the engineering experiments are not necessarily designed to produce very much knowledge, whereas standard experiments are conducted to gain new knowledge. Engineering experiments are conducted to check the feasibility of the design and to check the stability of the design parameters, as well as take into account the possible risks that are involved. Now that we are familiar with the important similarities and differences between engineering and standard experiments, we shall move on to the last topic of the video, which is engineers as responsible experimenters. While engineers play a vital role in designing, execution and production, the responsibility of the experiment does not solely depend on the engineers. Everyone, from the marketing strategist to the public who utilize these products, has a shared responsibility. But an engineering professional has to undertake the unique responsibility of monitoring the entire process, foreseeing and identifying any potential risk factors, protect the safety of human subjects and ensure their informed consent, taking accountability for any failures, ensuring technical competence for tackling any risks or potential side effects, lead by example, be adept at conflict resolution, etc. Apart from these, an engineer should also undertake the moral and ethical responsibilities in the experiment and shoulder them throughout the process. With that, we have reached the end of part 1 of module 3, Professional Ethics. Thank you for listening.